Okay, so I've got the wheels ready. I know my size wheels. I've got the bushing. I've got the bronze bushing. It's going to go inside the wheel. So that'll get drilled out to a half inch. I've got the rod that's going to be the axle. And I'm going to have one of these flat washers on either side of the wheel kind of hidden down in here. So I'll drill into here. But now I need to make a support piece over on this side. And so you remember my, my drawing is here. So that's what I'm making right now. I've got this kind of really fleshed out, and I just made this. I still left it square like this, or rectangular, so I can do the work on the drill press. And then once I get the drill press work done, and then I'll go ahead and just cut that off, and then cut my slot in here for the drawer bottom to go in. The dotted line represents the drawer bottom. But I've got a couple more things to do to get this ready. But over here you can see, here are my pieces. And I just made these really quickly on the table saw. I just, I cut those rabbits just using the fence. First I cut them all the length. I planed and joined them, got them all reference right, cut them to length, and then I did all cut those shoulders just on the table saw with the fence. So it was pretty quick. And I couldn't have made this cut anyway since it was too big, so I just made a cut using, here was the fence, and I just made a cut like this as far back in as I felt comfortable. Actually, it was on this side. So you can see, I didn't cut all the way here, so I just need to break this free right here and then clean that up a little bit. And then cut some shoulders here and get this ready to go. But let me show you my setup here where I'm breaking that waist piece out. Of course, here I'm using my always handy Texas Ribot bench. And the thing it's just a beast for holding just anything under the sun you can dream up. And I'm gonna just go ahead and free this. I got my aggressive Japanese saw with this is the rip side, this is the cross cut, so I'm gonna use the rip to cut down into this, and this is Liptis. This stuff is just brutal. But you can see that it's handling it quite easy, and you can see that I'm using my fingers to push the saw over. This is my reference side, so I want that, that's what I want to cut to. So that'll just keep the chisel work to a minimum or maybe nothing. Yeah, I got a little bit, but I'll do that in the next setup. This is the one that I snuck up on it with, so you can see where I made multiple cuts while I was sneaking up to my exact dimension. And this dimension here is the width of the wheel, which is 25 millimeters plus the washers plus a little bit of slop, so this is 29 millimeters, a little over an inch. I made the wheels exactly one inch thick, 25.4, because that's what the bushings were. Since I'm here in the U.S., use the right side. I'm here in the U.S., everything with that kind of stuff is going to be SAE.
Thank you.
Okay, so I've got all my pieces, all these are, you know, cut, and I got the mortises cut and everything squared off. So I put them back up here. I erased my old original pencil marks, and I put pencil marks exactly at where these tenons are. And then I transferred my marks down. I put a scribe line there because that's where the router is going to cut to. And these are just reference lines so I don't mess up and cut outside. But so what I've got here is I know where this is going to go. The next thing let me show you over here on this side so you can see it in the corner. So there they are. They're the ones over here. So, you know, this is going to go like this. Get dropped down in here at that exactly flush, and I'll mess with the router to get those settings exactly right. So the next thing I'm doing, I have to take my dry fit apart and to do this router work. I can't cut up that close. And so what I'm getting ready to do now is I'm getting ready to define where my axle is going to go in these two things. And so I took this, I took one of my wheels and I set it up on this to where it's sticking out exactly 1 inch. That's what I've said. And I've got it clamped to that. So I've got a transfer punch here, and I'm just going to put a little mark with the transfer punch down into the wood, and then I'll take a measurement, and then that'll be the distance. And that'll be the distance down. And then I put this up here like this, and I mark that inside shoulder, and I know I've got a little bit of slop on either side, so I put a real accurate scribe mark on all four corners that I can transfer down to whatever that scribe mark is that I'm going to put here for this transfer punch mark. Here, let me do that right now. Let's just determine what that is so it's not confusing. So it's just consistency of measurement. It's not the exact measurement that's that critical. I mean, whether this was 7/8 or what have you, it's not that critical. It's just critical that I get them all the same. So let's take a look at that to see what that measurement is. So I'll just bisect that transfer punch mark with my. See, the measurement isn't even really that important as long as I just get it right. Yeah, so it's a little over 1/2 inch, you know, like 9/16. So that looks real good. So now I'm going to come in here. So I've got my really light mark right here, and I'm going to come in here and I'm going to take my marking knife, which I left on the other side when I was. Oh no, here it is. I'm going to take my marking knife, and I'm going to put a mark right here. I'm going to scribe on the bottom of my square. So let me do all these first with this setting, and then I'll come back and extend this down and I'll make the cross so I know where it is. And then I'll, before that I will mark this too. I need to mark this also because this is the same distance down. So I don't want to change that setting. Okay, so now if I do this, I've definitely defined a top and bottom. So I'm gonna say this is a bottom. You know, because I put my mark here. Thanks for watching. We have woodworking plans available in our store and we'll continue to add more. Each set of plans corresponds with a free video series available on YouTube.